we practice in the follower, if you really related already, you have connection, received many teachings many times, you know, refuge vows and bodhicitta vows and Pandrayana, empowerment and Mahamudra instructions, all that Lama give you some benefits and you realize something and you learn something. That's the reality, that's you already have, right? So that doesn't matter, Lama broken vow, your quality is still, you got there. For example, like a middle school teacher, your middle school teacher who give you really good foundation of you know, education, knowledge, and that you already got it. You are wisdom. You got wisdom from them. But that middle school teacher something mistake, going jail or something, doesn't matter for you. That's his problem. Right? That's not your problem. You don't need judge for that. What you got is all here, you wisdom and already that's God. So that way, individually, if you have connection already, I don't think that's a good idea to complaining. It's not good karma. Remember the Raga's praise, you know, the Lama is, Raga's praise not for that, but normally, the Lama is, he lost the first vow, like marriage, but he remaining other vows. But doesn't mean he lost bodhicitta, compassion mind. He doesn't mean he lost something deity, you know, something idam, deity's practice. Who knows that remaining? Who knows he having wife? It's called Pandrayana way, it's called Karma Mudra, you know? Karma Mudra. So who knows? He's taking Karma Mudra as path or something. We don't know. We cannot judge. Right? We never know. Nobody knows that. Right? Only himself knows. So that kind of reality, reasonable, he has bodhicitta and realization or something like that. We cannot judge. Therefore, if you have already connection, better not broken samaya. You know, it's, and no criticism is better. You know, it's Raga's pray. Remember, Raga's pray says, "We never know where is Bodhisattva. Who is Bodhisattva?" Anyone, you know? Bodhisattva complaining or criticizing Bodhisattva to a Bodhisattva is the karma, that heavy karma is killed like three world beings. Heavy than that. Raga's pray, do you chanting that? Raga's pray, you know? So, that kind of, so who knows who's Bodhisattva? So even though first vow is lost, so therefore it's no criticism for that. But okay, however, in order to protect Buddhism, Buddha's teaching clear and clean, publicly, if he doing mistake like still having robes and, you know, if you see those mistakes, then you should stop. You should not support for that. That doesn't mean you broken samaya, right? So you're helping, trying to help, right? To right things to do, right? How nice when he lost vows immediately, if lost vows today, immediately change normal clock and being normal people. How nice, you know, it doesn't impact any Buddhism. any destroying any Buddhism. So that's how nice, how honest. So unfortunately, maybe some lamas be sort of like hiding and sort of like embarrassing or something, high title and too embarrassing to lose the, you know, title or role, something like that. That's not good. So it's everything very specific needs to be clear, you know. Yes is yes, no is no. Good karma is good karma, bad karma is bad karma. So it's neat. Yeah, it would be to be clear, you know, something like that. So then also the robes are difficult. You see, normally people see the, looks like all Tibetan Buddhism looks like a same robes, like a green color, just like that. Actually not. So the monk's robes has stripes. This kind of stripes. The skirt has stripes, you know. The bottom stripe, like this much high, like wide, and top here, this much wide, like that. So stripes. So other looks like everything like wearing yellow or maroon color, but they don't have those things. When you look detailed, you know. So the clear message is, okay. Nagarjuna said, as I said, wherever the five poison influence, that is negative. That is mistake. Wherever the positive is positive. And Adisha, the great teacher Adisha said, monastic should not action. Tantrayana has full empowerment, you know, like that. Okay, so your question, because related, I should say this. Tantrayana has four, you know, the highest supreme Tantrayana called Anuttara Tantra. Okay, so that has four empowerment. So Tibetan Vajrayana Buddhism, some people not monastic. So that's their practice, not monastic. So some people has, you know, it's called karma mudra. So that's called second empowerment and third empowerment. Second empowerment called a secret empowerment. Third empowerment called wisdom empowerment. So wisdom empowerment, second and third empowerment, because of Tantrayana, that the ritual, ceremony, it sounds like Ngakpa community. If it's Ngakpa community, they have some sort of that for the empowerment, they have some activities of, you know, Dharma Mutra, something like that. I don't really know. I never been there. So the message clear from the Adisha said, monastic Tantrayana practitioner should not take the second empowerment and third empowerment. There is a way to take that empowerment without Dharma Mudra. It's called Chulam. More like by the teaching, more like the teaching by example, more like visualization and instruction point out. So that way to realize the fundamental clear, it's called clear awareness, clear light. So the Ngakpa groups, the Karma Mudra, that in order to realize that clear light. So reason is that, I think. I don't really know much about that. So anyway, the message is clear. Adisha made, monastic should not take. Monastic is monastic. It's more important, more restrict, more, how do you say, strict to the Vinaya is most important. Based on that, then every practice, based on that, Vinayana. Same thing, our lineage, Digun lineage, founder of Digun lineage, Jigden Sumgon Ranashiri, Jigden Sumgon said, Mahamudra and moral ethic should not separate. Mahamudra and moral ethic is the same thing. It's like a hand this way and this way. You know? This way is Mahamudra, turn back is moral ethic. So cannot separate. It's like sort of the same thing in the root. So that kind of strict discipline and moral ethic. You know, so these are very clear messages, so okay.
Sorry, it's too hard.
Big challenge. 传统来讲呢，有些传承，比如说是宁玛派的，他们，有分两个部分。第一部分是出家人，他们是遵守的这个出家的戒律。然后呢，另外一个部分就是修习密宗的人，他们其实不一定是出家人，他们可能有可能只是一种传承而已。然后呢，在有一些特殊的情况下呢，有一些可能出家人到了西方世界，然后他们可能就跟正常人一样的工作，然后上班，然后可能时间久了，可能他们就有一些不太习惯，或者是觉得有可能有些格格不入，跟现实有些格格不入，所以说他们对这个戒律呢，就可能就有比较犹豫，所以他们最终可能会决定去舍戒，然后还俗。但是虽说他们是这个把这个出家戒律舍掉了，但是呢，其实很多人呢，还是其实是遵守绝大部分的戒律的。他们可能就是比如说，因为第一条戒，比丘戒呢有250条，其中有四大根本重戒，然后第一条呢是就是不可以有性行为。然后可能这些人呢，可能最后结婚了，他们可能犯了这条戒，但是其他的249条，他们可能还是遵守的很好的。所以说，他们这些人，你别不要看他们这些，有些出家人还俗了，然后就觉得他们怎么样怎么样，其实呢，他们还是比很多人要好很多。有一些喇嘛呢，可能就是行为有一些可能出格，比如说他们就是带着仁波切的这么一个头衔，然后呢又出了家，但是呢又结了婚，然后却保留了他的那个僧服，这个其实是然后还去给人教课、教佛法什么的，教课是 OK 的，但是呢，穿僧服在破戒以后穿僧服呢，其实是不合规矩的，而且他们也不能被允许给俗家人受戒，所以这是一个问题。但是呢，如果有些人呢，已经有这么一个因缘，从这种喇嘛。就是接受了传承，不管是密宗啊、大手印啊等等的，哪怕他毁了戒呢，你还是不应该作为一个弟子呢，还是不应该去指责他， 而且呢，你受的戒呢，其实是还是真实的。比如说，你的中学老师啊，哪怕是这个他犯法了，锒铛入狱了，其实他也不会影响到你已经学到的一些知识，对不对？你学到的东西呢，是你自己的，老师可能会有他的问题，所以说这不能去指责你的老师。所以说如果已经有这么一个因缘的话呢，就也不要去抱怨，或者不要去指责，因为这个其实是不太好的，可能会造一些恶业。因为这个是有一个现实，就是我们其实我们的肉眼凡胎是看不清很多菩萨的，很多大菩萨摆在我们面前我们也看不出来。比如说其实很多时候呢，事情的现象不一定是真实的本质，就比如说你看到他犯了这条戒或者怎么怎么的，其实呢他可能有他的理由，但是我们作为凡夫我们其实是看不出来的，因为我们看不清事情的这个起因，我们没有这个智慧去真正懂得真正看到前因后果。所以说所以说不要去指责。但是呢，如果说为从保护这个佛法的角度来讲，如果你看到有人这个犯戒了，然后呢你应该要去尽量的去阻止他，这个呢就不算是犯这个三昧耶戒，这是反而是一种智慧，因为是为了保护这个佛法。所以